Hey everyone, and welcome back to yet another episode on the Agent Development Kit. One of the nice things about using the ADK is that you actually get out of the box a nice user interface that allows you to interact with your various different agents. So let's use our speaker agent. Hello, please convert this. Agents are fantastic. It calls the text-to-speech agent, and then it gives you the location of the file. Wouldn't it be better if you could customize this UI to display some kind of widget that allows you to play the audio directly without you having to fumble around? So here's an example of what we'll be building today. I've created my own user interface that works with my speaker agent. Please convert to audio. AI agents are great with the ADK, especially with a custom UI. So as you can see here, it returns the same response, but because it's our custom UI, I've been able to add in an embedded audio widget that allows you to play the audio directly without having to locate the file yourself. For example,
AI agents are great with the ADK, especially with a custom UI.
The reason why this is important is because agents tend to be multimodal. You're not only dealing with text all the time. Sometimes you want to play back audio, like what we're doing here. Sometimes you want to show an image, or sometimes you even want to show code and run the code and present it to the user. So I'll be showing you today how you can call and run your agent via endpoints, how you can create your own custom user interface, and then you can present the information to your user in any possible way that you imagine. And so without further ado, let's get started. Now, before I forget, if you've been enjoying this series, you might want to check out the AI-oriented Insiders Club. It's free to join. You'll be able to get access to some additional material. For example, full lesson summaries, early previews of upcoming lessons, and beyond that, there'll be other exclusive content for subscribers. And if you subscribe today, you'll actually be able to get early access into the next tutorial, which will be about the agent-to-agent or A2A protocol. Now, if all that sounds interesting to you, head on right over to this URL, subscribe, and you'll gain immediate access to the Insiders Club that has all of these resources for you. All right, so let's get into what we'll be building today. If you've just cloned a repository, you want to do git checkout and then do lesson 2. This will take you to the end state of the last lesson, which would be the starting point for today's lesson. Now, the first thing that you want to be doing is that you need to update your requirements TXT file, add in these 4 extra dependencies, which will be required for today's lesson. The next thing that you want to do is make sure that you've activated the virtual environment. So I'm going to just do deactivate just to be sure. And then the next thing I'll do is source venv bin activate, which is where I have my virtual env. And then I'll do pip install minus r requirements.txt. This is so that you pick up all of the dependencies that we just added. Let's clear the screen. The next thing that we'll need to do is change the agent ever so slightly. So if you go into the agent subfolder and look for speaker, and then you go to agent.py, what you're gonna do today is that we're just gonna modify this instruction a little bit. And the reason for that is that right now, it doesn't actually say where and how it will save the file. The problem with this current instruction is that it says, return the result from the tool expected to be a URL. And if you try this out, sometimes it actually doesn't give you the file path until you prompt for it. And we want to make sure that whenever we call our agent, that it actually gives us the file path. So the change that we'll be doing today is we'll just replace the instruction with the following. When the tool returns a file path, format your response like this example. I've converted your text to speech. The audio file is saved at, and then it gives you the path. And then I said, make sure to only put the file path within the backtick. So you'll see that there's backticks here and here. And then finally, never modify or abbreviate the file path. This exact format is critical for proper processing. And this is really important because now it guarantees that whenever we send and run the message, that it's going to give it back to us in this format. So let's just run this using the ADK web version, and then we'll see how this works. I'm going to go into the agents folder, and I'm going to do ADK web, and this is running. And now I'll switch over to the ADK web view just to test that everything is working correctly. All right, so we are in the UI. We are going to change this to speaker, convert this to audio. The ADK is great. I'm having fun with this tutorial. And what we want to see is that it's going to return the response in the format we specified. As you can see here, it does the same thing, but this time it says, I've converted your text to speech. The audio file is saved at, and then it gives you the path. You can see that the font is different because it's put it in those backticks that we specified. So now we know that it's working correctly. So just switching back to our code, as you can see, we specifically told it to reply in this way. And because of these backticks, that's why the path was formatted in the way that it was shown. And this is really important because without this, we wouldn't guarantee that the agent would actually give us the path because sometimes it says, I've done it, but then you have to then query it in order to get the path. So now the question is that how do we go about exposing the functionality of the agent through an API rather than running it through ADK Web? The great thing about the ADK is that rather than you running ADK Web here, this time you run ADK API Server. And what this will do is that it will automatically start a server, and then it will provide you all the endpoints for free and automatically for you to be able to call each and every one of your agents using endpoints. Let me just show it to you here. If you just change this URL and put /docs behind it, it will give you something called the Swagger UI, which is a list of all the endpoints that your server is running. And the ADK uses something called Fast API, which you may or may not be familiar with, but it's effectively a Python library that allows you to serve endpoints in a very easy manner. And then it gives you this Swagger interface for debugging. So for example, you can go here and you can say, list all the apps, and it will list all of the agents that you have defined in your agents folder automatically for you. The next thing you will want to do is run commands and functions against your agent using this run endpoint. There are a lot of endpoints over here, and you don't really need to get into too much detail. The whole purpose of this is that it's trying to basically provide you with endpoints that allows you to create your own custom apps, your own custom interfaces, so you don't have to rely on the ADK Web to do all of that for you. Now, the downside to doing everything by yourself is that when you use ADK Web, the ADK will automatically create a user for you, and then sometimes it'll create a session for you. It does a lot of these things automatically for you. When you're creating your own user interface, you're going to handle your own user creation and your own user sessions by yourself, and then you're going to have to manually call your agents yourself. This is to be expected. When you're having access to the raw endpoints, you're going to have to wire things up yourself. But as I'll show you, it's not difficult at all. It's actually very simple. Now, the great thing about using ADK API Server is that you don't need to write any other code to use your agent via an endpoint. And that's the beauty about using the ADK tools, and you can actually simply wire it up with whatever UI you want, and it'll work fine, as long as you follow the format and the standards of the protocol. I'm going to show you how you can test this right now. If you create a folder and just call this scripts, and then create a folder called tests, and then just to make things neat, call this speaker, because these are all the speaker test scripts that you're going to be using. I'm going to start off with creating something called test extract audio.sh. This is just going to be a bash script. We're going to start off every bash script by adding this so that we can run this as a script. I'm going to add a little bit of a README so that we know what we're doing. It's going to expect the response from the agent to follow this format. This is actually the ADK response format, which I put here just for you to know. We want to look for it to respond with something that says file saved as, and then with the file path. Now, we want to define a couple of key things. And this one should be the name of your agent that's listed in your agents folder over here. The next thing that you need to do is that you do a user ID, and this can be just test user. It doesn't really matter. Create a session ID, call it test audio extraction, and with the date and time that the script was called so that it can uniquely identify this session. You're going to need to create a new session calling a post against this endpoint. If you will recognize that this endpoint is actually one of the endpoints that's exposed by the ADK. This is just a standard endpoint with the format that it expects for you to initialize a session with the agent. You can see that we are just filling in the app name, the user ID, and the session based on what we've defined over here. We're going to have a brief pause. And then the next thing we want to do is call the run endpoint of the agent. Here we go. It's going to send a message. And these are the parameters that it expects. You're going to need the app name, the username, and the session ID. Please say hello. And then I'm going to send it as the role, as the user. When you pass in a session over here, it's going to require that you've actually created the session prior to this. I'm going to print the full response just for debugging purposes. Then this snippet of code that will look through the response, see whether there is actually a file path with an MP3 format within the response. And you don't really need to know the details here. I actually use cursor to generate this code. In essence, what it does is pattern match the response, and it determines whether the test is passed if it can find the extracted path. So let me show you how to get this running. You need to be running ADK API server within the agents folder. So I've left it running since just now. I'm going to split the terminal over here so you can actually see both of them running at the same time. I'm just going to hop into the root folder, clear the screen. What I want to do is to do chmod plus x, and then you do scripts test speaker text extract audio.sh. The reason why you do that is so that you can actually execute the script like this. So you do /scripts test speaker test extract audio.sh. And let's just run the test right now. On the right-hand side is the script running the test. On the left-hand side is the server receiving the command. And this is great because now you can see that the test has actually passed. There is an extracted audio from the response that you found and placed it on my desktop, and we can play it back here.
Hello.
The great thing about running it this way through the terminal is you can actually see that the test script did call the server, and you can actually look through and determine what to do. You can see that it called the 11labs MCP servers, which wraps around the API, and then it provide the system instruction that we defined, as you can see over here. Finally, it responded in the way that we expected, because it says, I've converted your text-to-speech, your audio file is saved here. Our test script was able to extract the audio information, and so the test has passed. Now you know how to call and run your agents without using the ADK web interface, but just by calling the endpoints directly. And now that you've done this, the last that we're going to do is create our own frontend that is able to hit this endpoint, extract out the audio, just like we've done in our test script, and then present it in a nice way for our user. So let's see how we're going to do that. Let's go back to our code. We're going to create a new folder called apps. We're going to create a new app, and we'll call this speaker app. We'll be using something called Streamlit, a Python library that allows you to create user interfaces programmatically using Python, which is great because the rest of our code base is in Python. Now you could extend upon this and use TypeScript and something like React to create your own user interface. For this tutorial, I decided to keep everything in Python. If you would like to see a TypeScript React example, do let me know in the comments and I could do one just to showcase how it would work. But a lot of what I'm going to be doing here would be very similar. All right, so I'm going to put some doc string to explain what this app is. It's just going to provide a chat interface for interacting with the ADK agent. A few things that we're going to be needing is that it needs to be running on localhost 8000. And this is actually automatically what happens when you run ADK API server. I'm just going to run it here one more time for you so you can see, but you can see it's actually running at localhost 8000. And the related package is installed. We've already done that. Cool. So I've already done this, ADK API server, ensure that the speaker agent is running. We've checked it just now by running our tests, which you can see right over here. And then we should be able to create a session and start chatting. So the first thing we're going to do is import our dependencies. These are the ones that we're going to need for today. First of all, we're going to set some configs. So we're going to call it the speaker agent chat. We're going to add an icon, which is a megaphone, and we're just going to center everything in the layout. The next thing we're going to do is define a few constants. So API base URL, so that's localhost 8000, and then the app name is speaker. It needs to match what you name here because that's how the ADK identifies the different agents by apps. And then a bunch of things just to do a bunch of boilerplate to get set up. So I want to initialize a user ID, a session ID, and then the messages and audio files to keep a record of all the messages and audio files that have been created. Finally, we're going to define, and then we'll be defining two methods. We'll be defining two methods, which we'll go into more detail. First of all, it's going to be create session, which we'll define shortly. And then another one is send message, which we'll also define shortly. Now let's finish up the rest of the Streamlit application of it here, because it's actually just laying out how the elements appear on the screen. You can get the code. All of this code is in the repository. The main thing it does is that it sets a title, has a sidebar, so that you can create your sessions in the sidebar. And then you have another interface, which is the chat interface. And then it will display the chat in a nice available way, depending on whether it's the user or the assistant. Finally, it's going to give you the input to be able to chat with the agent. So these two methods are the only two that we need to finish up right now. But the create session one is effectively going to do what our test script does. It's going to create a unique session and then send a post request to the ADK, and then it updates the session state. So the way you would session, and then it goes based on the time that this function was being run, perform a post operation against that same endpoint with the app name, the user ID, and the session ID. Make sure you've set the content headers correctly, and then you want the data to be nothing, because this is just a GET request. There's no data you need to pass in for this one. And then what you want to do is just check the response. So if it's 200, which is an OK, then you just set the session ID that you get back from the ADK API, and then you initialize your messages and audio files. Otherwise, you just do an error. And so that's it for the create session method. And the next one is the send message method. What you're going to do is that I'm going to put the doc string here. So what it's going to do is just going to send a message, right? It always adds the user message to the chat history, and then it sends the message to the ADK API URL. It processes the response to pull out the text and audio, and then it will make sure to update the chat history so that you can display it nicely. And most importantly, it will use the run endpoint of the ADK API. To start things off, if there's no session, it will remind you to create a session first before trying to send anything. Otherwise, you add the session state to the messages. You add the message from the user into the session to kick things off. Run a post against the run endpoint with the app name, user ID, session ID, the message you want to send. Now, this is the message that will be called with the message that you want to send. And you can see this is actually very, very similar to our test script, right? Because we created a session over here, sent the message, and then waited for the response. So that's the reason why you always want to start off with a test script rather than wiring everything up in the UI and then figuring out whether it's the UI that's the problem or whether it's the way that you're calling the API test script ensures that you can get to a working state before you deal with anything with the UI. All right, so with that response, the first thing you always do is check whether it's 200. If it's not, then you give an error and then you give the text from the response. If it is 200, then you get the response as a JSON format. And then you'll be prepared. The next step we're going to do here is just try to extract out the MP3 path from the response. We initialize our variables here. The easiest way that you do this is that you just loop through the events that have come back with the response, right? And you always want to look for the most recent response through all the different responses that the AI provides. It matches the, it looks through the, so what this does is that it goes through all the responses from the AI and then the messages. And then kind of pattern matches, and then it tries to find the audio file path from the response. Based on if it finds a response, it will then try to extract out the MP3 file from it. The reason why we are so confident in doing so, because remember, in our agent, we say specifically to return it in this format. So we can be confident in the way that we are choosing to extract this out. There are actually other ways to do this. You can actually use a structured response and return it as it. But I just want to show you one method of doing it. That was very quick and easy, but in a subsequent tutorial, I'll show you how to use a structured response to make things even more certain that you'll be able to get what you want. Finally, you just want to add this back into your UI so you can see the results, and don't forget to return true at the end of this function. One of the things that I forgot to highlight, if you look into how we're displaying the messages, if we find an audio path within the message, what we'll do is that we'll actually use this st.audio from Streamlit, which provides an audio player widget. And then we'll put that path into that audio widget so that we can play the audio that's generated within the UI itself. All right, so here we go. What you can do is you can do Streamlit run apps speaker app, and this will actually start off a Streamlit app in your browser. So let's switch over to the browser and take a look. All right, so you should see your Streamlit app up and running. Click on create session to begin. You will see that it's created a session name based on the format that we defined earlier. And now you should be able to do something like the following. Convert to audio. If you are enjoying this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications to be the first to know when new content drops. You can see in the top right-hand corner that it is running. It will show you the message you sent, as well as the agent's reply. It's given you the audio file. Because we're using our own custom UI that's able to embed the audio widget within the app, we can play it right away.
If you are enjoying this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like. Also, subscribe and turn on notifications to be the first to know when new content drops.
And there you have it. You've created your own custom UI that's able to interact with your agents via an endpoint rather than using ADK Run or using ADK Web. Now you can create custom user interfaces to give your users that interact with your agents the best possible experience. Rather than dealing only with text, you can show them an image, play audio, and potentially provide other forms of interaction so that you don't have to rely solely on text input and output. Now, I really hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. Don't forget to give it a like if you found it useful. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so that you'll be the first to know when new content drops. Till next time, see ya.